Hello, gang. This is Tony Torres here from Defense Lab Tactical, Defense Lab TNT, and Edge Protection Systems. This weekend, I'm in beautiful Hayes, Texas, training some police officers, security personnel. This is where this beautiful space, Defense Lab Hayes, for Hayes County, I believe, and this is where we're conducting the training. So I figured I'd do the blog. So this one is to answer a direct question we had from Mark Cummings. Mark Cummings wanted me to talk a little bit about how to deal with aggression before it becomes physical. So last week's vlog, we already talked a little bit about, you know, being relaxed, being alert, you know, aware of your surroundings and all those things that you have to have in place. But now you have somebody that's being aggressive towards you. What things can we do in order to mitigate the chances that that will turn into a physical fight? So one of the first things you want to remember is that sometimes you're facing a good person that's having a bad day, not necessarily a bad person. So when you're, you know, depending on the context, obviously if, you know, you had an accident in a parking lot or somebody jumps out of the car, you may want to factor in the fact that that person is a person that's not necessarily bad. They may be good having a bad day. Either way, whether it's just a bad person or a good person having a bad day, you want to apply some of the same rules in general. The first thing is we want our body language, which expresses the most amount of communication, to show non-aggression, but you also don't want to show weakness, because some people are inspired to attack you if they perceive that there's a certain amount of weakness there. So if I don't want the fight to get physical, then sometimes using a little bit of assertive body language without being aggressive, calmly assertive body language, is better than just trying to be too meek or too mild. So make sure that your shoulders are back, you're straight, you're looking at the person directly. And the next thing that factors in is the kind of tone of voice that I use. You don't want to use an aggressive, loud voice, because that may instigate a fight as well. You want to use calm and assertive tone. You don't want to speak too fast. It's very important that we don't speak aggressively. So some of the things that we want to watch out for: don't use violent language when you're trying to talk somebody into not fighting, because somebody that's excited or angry will only hear the violent language. So for example, don't use things like please don't hurt me, or I don't want to hurt you, we don't want to get into a fight anymore, or I don't want anybody to get punched. Don't use any words that express any type of physical violence, because all that person hears, whether you say please don't hurt me or please don't punch me or please, all they hear is hurt, punch, fight. They're in that state of mind that all they're hearing are the violent words. So we want to diminish the amount of violent words we use in our conversation. Again, calm, assertive body language, calm, assertive tone. Do not use any type of violent language. Try to keep the language a little bit vague. Hey, we don't have to do this. I apologize. That kind of language is better than specifically mentioning fighting words. The next thing you want to do is do not challenge anything they say as if they're lying to you, or give them any instructions directly. Especially in this, you don't want to tell a guy, this is the most famous instruction ever that has never worked in the history of any fight, is never tell anybody to calm down. Calm down has never worked to calm down anyone in the history of calming down. Don't ever tell people to calm down. Apologize, again, using a calm and assertive voice and calm and assertive language. Try to find out what it is they want from you. That may give them a chance to have a dignified way to not fight you. So do not challenge, do not threaten. Obviously, don't tell the guy, if you get any closer, I'm going to punch you. Number one, tactically, it's you're kind of defeating the purpose of the element of surprise. Again, it's a fighting word. He hears punch. That's all he can hear. And it might incite that subconscious program to exert violence. Calm but assertive body language, calm and assertive tone. Do not use violent words. do not threaten, do not challenge, do not call the person any names or lying. All of those things will help you be able to calm somebody down that may be having a bad day, or somebody that's just socially aggressive. You know, you got into an accident, he gets out with a little bit of road rage. Hey, motherfucker, what are you doing? Etc. Now, it changes a little bit. The dynamic changes when you're dealing with asocial violence. That means that somebody is robbing you, somebody is maybe trying to abduct you. Here, we kind of want to play a little bit different of a game. This is where we kind of use compliance and trickery to try to get ourselves in a position to better execute whatever it is we need to execute. In some limited cases, depending on what the interaction is, if it's a resource predator that's strictly from the conversation that you're having with him and he gives you all the right indications that all he wants is your property or your money, then we want to cooperate. We want to give them the money, we want to give them the property, whatever it happens to be. Obviously, if it goes beyond that, where it's your body or your life involved, then we want to use the language to set ourselves up to initiate our escape. So that's where we want to make sure that the person, we kind of appear compliant in order to be able to deploy our tactics. It's very important that the way you think, that you act, and the way you talk when you're being threatened by somebody that wants a resource from you, or perhaps a process from you, whether it's a rape, or they're about to murder you or kidnap you or something like that. And you understand that I want to give this person the sense that everything is going their way until I make that decision to figuratively pull the trigger and make my move. The times to make those moves are different. Every situation is different. In a future video, we can get into some of those specifics on how to deal with a physical kidnapping. But I hope that this answers the question from Mark Cummings about how do we get somebody that has not gotten physical yet, how can we deal with that situation or that part of the situation using our words and actions or our thoughts that are not necessarily actually fighting yet. If you have any other questions, please send them to go to our page. You can comment on the YouTube page below. You can go to our page, Defense Lab Tactical, Defense Lab TNT, or Edge Protection Systems, or you can call me at 520-236-2436. Thank you very much. I'll speak to you soon.